Alright, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good evening. Alright, so hi, I'm Michalina. Okay, so today, actually, I told you that previous class, as the first session, that we don't want to add you yet in the NEO because the students are still at and drop a week. So by next week, I'll be officially using NEO to be a part of our class platform, okay? Why? Because I learned from the previous semester because students keep on coming one by one again. And yeah, the process is something like not so very smooth, okay? So this time around, I want to everybody must be, okay, already ready by the second week. But today, for our class start at 4 until 5:30, I will touch a little bit on what will we learn, okay, for the first topic one, which is evolutions, concept, theories of the entrepreneurship and the business opportunity. Assalamualaikum again, okay, and a very good evening, all right. So for those, this is your first time with me, I'm Miss Norshalina Nordin. I'm from School of Business and Legal Studies, so this is actually officially my subject, okay, because since I'm working here, I never stop teaching this subject, so I hope that you are okay, and I will start, okay, the lecture right now. Right, so as you can see in the screen that I already sharing with you all right now, in topic one, we have actually two what we call sub topic, okay? Number one, we have evolution, concept, theories of entrepreneurship and business opportunities, okay? I hope that my voice is clear right now because just now I'm just adjusting about this. Yeah, my mic. All right, and then the another one is about the entrepreneurship and the business opportunity. So, each of the topic in entrepreneurship, we have numerous of subtopic, even though it's five topics. All right, okay. So as you can see at the next slide, okay, what we will learn, okay. In a topic objective, after studying this topic, the student should be able to, number one, define the earlier viewpoints and entrepreneurial studies. Okay, we will learn about who actually the researcher who introduced about the entrepreneurial studies. Okay, and then we will differentiate, okay, and define what is entrepreneur and entrepreneurships. And then for 1.3, okay, third subtopic is about identify Islamic entrepreneur. And then for subtopic number 4, it is explain the process of identifying and evaluating business opportunity. And the next one is discuss the process of selecting business opportunity. All right. So we're going to go to the next one. It's about the earlier viewpoints. Okay. Who is the entrepreneur and the scholars who involve, okay, in the entrepreneurship. Okay, so entrepreneur, as you can see, as the earlier viewpoint, entrepreneur is come from the words, French word, okay, and it's called as entrepreneur, okay, and which refers to the individual who undertake the risk of the new venture. So basically this word is come from the word French, okay, and it's called entrepreneur. And entrepreneur is categorized as the person who are taking the risk, okay, new venture to their business, to the process of their set up their own empire, okay. And based on the history, the word entrepreneur was firstly used by the Richard Cantillon in 1755, who was an economist. So the first word is come from French, and the Richard Cantillon also from French, and of course is the guy who actually used the words entrepreneur. So mostly basically we always heard the words like businessman, seller, okay, but In our class, we use the words entrepreneur. Okay, some say entrepreneur, and how you pronounce it, maybe you can refer to your English lecturer on that. But I used to call it is entrepreneur, or maybe you can call it the print day. Okay, all right. So the next one, as you can see, okay, the Richard Cantillon in 75, okay, in 1755, entrepreneur is invest, transform, and makes profit and losses. On the other hand, Cantillon sees the entrepreneur as an agent who buys manufacturing tools to produce a product that can be marketed. Okay, however, entrepreneurs have to take the risk. So when we're talking about entrepreneur, the first of all, the category, the character that they have used to be is number one, have to bear with the high risk. Okay, the theory is simple that you learn in other classes, business, right? For example, if you take high risk, you will have a high return. Okay. Tinggi risiko, maka di sebaliknya anda akan mempunyai banyak pulangan. Okay, that is the theory, theory part. When you have the low risk, actually you have the low return. So, when we're talking about how does entrepreneur invest, transform and makes the profit and loss, this is talking about how does entrepreneur talking about the future, how the entrepreneur talking about when they investing something, they look into something like whether this investment, okay, because of course when people are doing investment, they want to have something that in return. I never heard that people doing the investment, they don't want in return, right? So when we're talking about the profit and loss in here, they see in the something like in the 2-3 years in the future, okay, that this is potential to have given some investment to them in terms of the money, in terms of the maybe like their own product, okay, product development, image, services become maybe more worth it and value added to the society, okay? And as you can see also, they say entrepreneur as an agent, okay? So when we're talking about is an agent, it's something like intermediaries because they buy the manufacturing tools and then they try to produce a product from input to output, okay? This is talking about transformational process, okay? And of course, how we think about that the product can be marketed because it's raw, something that we can't see, even that maybe just a piece of paper. We do not know that this piece of paper will become in a bulk and become a book. So this is how we think it. And then yeah, of course, entrepreneur have to take a risk, right? And then the second one is according to the Adam Smith. Okay, not like I think that maybe you have heard this guy's name. Okay, very popular in economic subject. Okay, in 1776, entrepreneur is the person who possess, okay, the ability to foresee potential through the changes in the economy and to act on the demand which are being created. So when we're talking about the person who possesses the ability, okay, meaning to say that has to see that certain things that have to have some potential, because when we're talking about the some potential, meaning to say in here, we are talking about how does it can be moving from one item to another item in one economy process and how we can actually create the demand. Because in when we're talking about the process of the business, we are talking about the demand and supply, okay? We are talking about how much the people want demand on that product and how many people can actually market it and how those people can supply it. That is the process of the business. There is a buyer, there is a seller, and then there is a transaction between the money involving and you can give the product and services in return. So that is according to Adam Smith, okay? And then we're moving to the James Baptist say. If you realize the name all come from the Western country because we are using the, of course, the Westerners book, textbooks, right? Okay, so maybe one name you will see that Islamic scholars. In 1803, entrepreneur exhibited certain competency in creating enterprise. So the words enterprises in here is talking about the company. Okay, they are talking about the company. They are talking about organization, okay, and the entrepreneur was said to influence the society to recognize needs and fulfill them through the skillful management of resources. Okay, I said to you all in the previous class, in order to take this subject, you have to pass PPOM, okay, right? Principle and Practice of Management, blah blah blah, BUS 1231, right? So when we're talking about skillful management or the management process, or we're talking about what is the process of management? Remember, we have P, we have O, we have L, we have C, and I like to add the word S. Okay, when we're talking about POLC, we are talking about P is planning. Okay, we are talking about O is organizing. We are talking about L is leading. And we're talking about C is controlling. Okay, and the S one is talking about staffing. Okay, not staffing that you have many things in front, in your environment. No. Staffing. Staffing meaning to say that you are recruiting the right people at the right place, at the right job, at the right time. Okay? So when we're talking about POLC in here, in order to create the enterprise itself, we have to have a good planning. Okay? To have a good planning, number one, we should have a good planner. We have to create who is the planner of the company, who is the good planner for the enterprise. Okay? That's why, according to the Jeep's best this day, okay, he said that entrepreneur have to say to influence the society, because this kind of person able to influence the society to buy their product. Maybe they are something like the spokesperson, maybe they are a celebrity, maybe they're something like public figure. Okay, they've been chosen in order to influence the customer to buy your product. Okay, that is a part of that one. Good planner, right? Number two, we're talking about organizing. How you delegating a certain task to make sure that who is the right person to do the marketing, who the right person to lead the group, okay, lead the company, who is the right person in order to do the human resource task, who is the right person to do the operation task, who is the right person in order to do the financial accounting and so forth. Okay, so this is what we call as organizing. And we're talking about L, leading. Who is leading every single part of the department? Example, okay? Who is the leader for the marketing task? Okay? Who is the leader for operation department? Who is the leader for administrative department? Who is the leader for marketing department? So we are talking about how to fulfill, okay, the skillful, because every single person, okay, basically, okay, what to say to you all, the most important, the value change in the company is, number one, we have admin. Okay, admin. Second, marketing. The third one, we have operation. And the last one, we have financial and accounting. So the four, basically, these four, when you have the good leader in here, they're interrelated and collaborated each other, and they become very well-versed, okay, in terms of their skills and how they manage their company. I believe that the company can become successful. Of course, the company is also like your, what we call roller coaster, sometimes up, sometimes down, right? So when we have a good teamwork, we have to lead a good, what we call employees, okay? When we have the good leader leading, okay, all those people, I believe it can be better and better, right? Okay, and the last one, we have controlling. Of course, when we are doing marketing, the example, we need a lot of people, okay, to sell the product, because we know that there will be a demand and there will be a buyer. But at the same time, when you do those, okay, massive marketing, for example, we have to know that somehow, not everything has to be bought, okay, in one shot, okay? What we have to do, we have to control, okay? How to control it? That's why we have the finance and accounting department. They are the department who control the money in and out, okay? Because we are talking how you want to actually delegate whether the task, when is the marketing should be done, how many the budget should be done. And every single this department have to report to the finance and accounting department, okay? So what I'm trying to say in here, we have to control. If not, the expenses is more than budget. Okay, if that happen, there will problem to the company. Okay, we couldn't spend any singles of the penny. I mean, like a single cent that we have in the company in order to do everything. Okay, in one shot, we have to bear in mind the marketing take process, and every single process of the business must be, okay, have their in return first. Then we can see whether the strategy is good things or bad things happen. Okay. All right. And then we're moving to the John Stuart Mill, 1848. Okay. This guy said entrepreneurship in the private enterprise, enterprise which warranted entrepreneurs to be accounted as the fourth factors of the production. So mostly in your economic classes, maybe we have heard about land, labor and capital, plus we have also entrepreneur, okay? And the entrepreneur function to assemble this factor for the production. So they said in here, fourth factor of the production, meaning to say we need the entrepreneur to control those links. Okay, why I say so? Number one, Who looking for the strategic land? Of course, the entrepreneur. Who is looking for the right labor? Okay, because we want to recruit the right people at the right place, at the right job, at the right position, and at the right time, right? And then that's why we have to make sure that this labor is a really worth to recruit. Okay, and then we have the capital. Of course, entrepreneur is the one who are looking for the capital to start off their enterprise, to start off their company. So that's why we need to make sure that we have the sufficient of the capital in order to embark, okay, of our business. All right. Okay. Now we have to move on, okay, to the next one. We have the Karl Menger, okay. Karl Menger said in 1871, because if you see the year is according to the timeline, okay, from the old one into the latest one, all right. And then if you realize, Karl Menger stated, entrepreneurs are economic agents who transform resources into goods and services. When you see the word transform services, is actually referring to the transformational process, okay, because we actually are transferring from the input to output, okay. And then if you realize an environment conducive to industrial growth, okay, so meaning to say entrepreneur is the economic agent, not just only a spy is the agent, but we are talking about the entrepreneur itself is, I can say, a part of, okay, when we want to do this kind of the transformation process. And according to Menger, he said entrepreneurs is able to visualize, of course, mostly the skill that have to the person who are willing and passionate, okay, to become entrepreneur, is they have a visualize skills, okay, how they want to visualize something in order to have, why not I do something like this idea from A to B, and I have to go with the C process, and you visualize it, okay, into your head and mind. Because why? Because that's their skills, okay? They want to make sure that the visual is become the reality. Okay? Of course, some people say you don't just dreaming, but you have the dream plus with the action. Of course, this is I'm trying to say to you all, okay? And then we have the Joseph Schumpeter in 1934. Entrepreneur is a creative destructive force. When we're talking about creative destructive force, is not a meaning of negative word. It's my meaning to say that this person is trying to become different way, okay? How you make something like a simple thing. Okay, let's say I'm giving some a very simple example to you all. Okay, let's say mostly that example, we have like this pen, okay. If you realize, okay, this is just a normal pen, right? It's like what we call, pen, magic color, something like that, right? So if you realize, if like this, I can call it marker, okay? This marker with this pink color, okay? We have the big one, with the big size of the marker, versus at the back they have the small one, okay, the small size of their what we call this one, something like the size of the pen, right? So this is one of the destructive force. Why I said so? Because normally pen or marker, we know it's only have one kind like this, okay. Okay, if like this, right? Okay, if you realize it's only have one, and there is no back at the back, but here they have front and back. So this is example of destructive force, because we want to see something like usual way to become in different way. Let's say how we want to improve this from back and front, like they have two marker here. Maybe we can have some destructive force by maybe putting some folder or no folder, something like function in here. Let's say we can open up here. From marker, maybe we can call something like ruler, something like the example. You can imagine it, right? Example, I put something like here. Okay, imagine when we want to use the ruler, let's say we can open up and become some ruler here. That is the idea that we call as destructive force, okay? Because we are thinking about something like from usual way to become something like introductions of the new ways. Okay, so in other words, we are trying to think out of the box. That is according to the Joseph Schumpeter. And this is the most good news to everyone, I believe, because we have the only, okay, the Muslim scholars in here. We have Ibn Khaldun, 1406, stated that entrepreneurs are the one who have incentive for the maximum efficiency and greater production through trade and specialization to gain the profit. So the entrepreneurs are the one who bear the consequences of their action in terms of the gain and losses. So what I'm trying to say in here, okay, entrepreneurs are the one have incentive for maximum, okay, efficiency. What's mean efficiency? Okay, if you still like throwback to your ITB classes or maybe like PPOM classes, efficiency is defined as the word like maximize profit, minimize cost. So meaning to say, you try to like maximize your profit by using a very, very minimal cost. Okay, I give a very simple example. Okay, Tony Fernandez, okay, maybe he tried to fulfill the space of the Boeing, okay, Boeing, Asia is using the Boeing, right, for example, maybe for like MAS, okay, the size of the Boeing, maybe only just, this is example, because I want you to imagine it, I want you to differentiate it, what's mean efficiency in here, okay. In one Boeing for Malaysia Airlines system, maybe they only can capacitate on only 100 passengers. But for the Asia, from 100 passengers in the same size of the Boeing, they can use to maybe 150 or 200 passengers in one of flight, for example. How they do it? Because they may be used to like altering a certain of how the space of the seat, okay, sitting of the passenger and so forth. That's why they can have many of the passengers to use the one of the destination of the flight. Okay, because the same thing, okay, with the very minimal scope, because everybody say, right, everyone can fly and the ticket is quite cheap. Okay, it's considerable cheap, right? Okay, but at the same time, they're able to maximize the profit. People when heard that only going to maybe Sarawak is only RM1. So everybody want to buy the ticket, right? So this is what we're talking about, how they want to maximize the efficiency. Okay. So maybe the another way around, maybe example. Okay, we have two ways in order to sending something like information or letter. Let's say. Number one, maybe they give, okay, you can send and write the letter and we use the postage. For example, like sending a letter by using stamp and so forth. Second way, we using email. Which one is more efficiency? Of course, the answer is email, because it's more efficient, it's more faster, it's more quick, and it's free. Okay. Yeah, of course it's free. Compared that we use, like example, sending a letter, we need to buy the stamp, we need to post, we go to post office, we need something like a lot of time, right? So when talking about the concept of efficiency just now, of course sending email is a very, very fastest way. Okay, I think that one is better simple example compared to the previous one. Okay, and then the entrepreneurs are the one who bear the consequences of their action in terms of gain and losses. So yeah, what we're talking about here, as entrepreneur, you also like me, I also like you all, when we trying to make something, one product, right, or we want to sell one product, of course in mind I want to get a profit. Simple example, one nasi lemak. Okay, your cost in order to do like doing that nasi lemak or coconut rice, sambal, ikan bilis, peanuts and cucumber. Simple, maybe the cost is around RM1. You sell for RM1.50 per pack, right? Per bungkus tu RM1.50. So you get 50 cents. In logic, you might say it's only 50 cents. Okay, what's the concept here? 50 cents, you have to times with 100 volume of packs. How much is that? It's RM50, right? So we base on the volume. Are you get me? The quantity. So if you just say that it's only 50 cents, the answer is wrong here. Because mentality, you have to bear in mind, even 50 cents, even 40 cents, 30 cents, 20 cents, 10 cents is considered as the profit. As long you can actually mark up their marginal cost. That one is marginal cost, we call. Okay. But if you buy, for example, like this tudung, you buy RM25 and then you sell for RM25, that one is, okay, what I'm trying to say, better you close your shop now, okay? So that is not entrepreneur after all that you are doing. It's not charity too. It's charity, you don't need to pay anything, right? So even RM25, 50 cents, you got 50 cents, is still considered as the profits. Okay, basic is that one is the basic knowledge, so everybody know. So if let's say you buy RM25 for the tudung, you sell it RM20, so that one is crazy, that one is called losses. Okay, so what I'm trying to say, as an entrepreneur, you have to be smart. Okay, we're not just chasing for one time. Of course, some people say we have to be like, bear in mind, we have to mark up. Yeah, yeah, we know that is the concept of the entrepreneur. But at the same time, you have to bear in mind, we based on volume. Okay, so when we're talking about based on volume, we have to know that there is probability to have to do in terms of, yeah, that is the probability of that. Huh? Okay, what else? Yeah, maybe we should go with the definition or differentiation between entrepreneur and entrepreneurship. Okay, like previously what I said to you all, what's the difference between this? Okay, entrepreneur, okay, without the word ship, we call as a person, okay? And entrepreneurship, when they have the word ship at the back, is a process, okay? So it's simple, entrepreneur, person, entrepreneurship, process. What's the difference means? Okay, entrepreneur is the innovator. They say it's stated, right? Innovator who use processes to challenge the existing norms via combinations of the new resources method in commerce. So for me, entrepreneur is someone who have fight themselves independent. They have to bear in mind with the consequences to bear the risk, whether it's high risk, low risk, moderate risk. So they have to challenge it, challenge themselves to do something like maybe something like different ways, okay? That is unknown. So when we're talking about something like it's not unknown, ataupun kita kata bukan norma, atau something like we try to challenge ourselves, okay? So actually we become more creative compared to we just follow and rigid to something without think out of the box. There will be a problem, okay? So for the entrepreneurship is the process. So if you ask me who is the entrepreneur, I give you one example, is Tony Fernandez. Actually many, okay? We have Tan Sri Azman, we have Dato Al-Bukhari. In Malaysia, we have many, like we have Nia Lofa, who else? We have Dato Siti Nurhaliza, who else? Okay, we have a lot of actually, okay, entrepreneurs out there. And for the entrepreneurship, when we're talking about the process, how the process to become entrepreneur, how they set up, how they sacrifice their time, okay, their money and family in order to become the entrepreneur, okay? So, like me, I give example, like just now, entrepreneur is Datuk Tony Fernandez. And for entrepreneurship, on how Datuk Tony Fernandez to set up AAsiaX to become a part of the CEO of the AAsiaX, right? Okay, so that is one example. Maybe you can also give some another example of popular public figures that involving, okay, in the kinds of entrepreneurship. Okay, so I think for this first class, okay, it's quite compact enough, right? But if you want to continue, okay, we have the another about Islamic entrepreneurship. Okay, maybe this one, okay, I will continue later, okay, in our next classes, okay, I mean like next class next week, okay, on Monday. Okay, see me again. Okay, inshallah during this time, that time, okay, this time, that time, we will use what we call live tutorial, live lecture. Okay, so yeah, that's it. Okay, so any question regarding for today's lesson, I want you to shoot in the our group WhatsApp. Okay, and then make sure that everybody who have ordered the books, okay, from the link that I announcing, and you still can make the order because this is a ongoing process. Bear in mind, I'm not touch anything regarding the process of packaging and delivering. It's all to the suppliers. And of course, make sure the you give the details of especially your correct address, okay? And then one more, once you got your manual, please snap your pictures together with the books and also the packaging, because I want to see how the process of their packaging, because I have to give the feedback to them, okay? And you can maybe counting on the days how many is delivered to you, because this is about the process, huh? All right, so this is also something we are talking about services, all right? So I think this is something like new norm to us, okay? And again, I wish you all the best today. I know this is not the right time to say all the best, but this is a welcome to the new semester and welcome to the new norms of our actually last semester already start, right? So this is a new semester that for semester one, okay? And I hope that everybody like you try to what we call together familiar with this kind of this kind of e-learning. It's not easy to say that, right? But I also doing the same thing because I believe that the student is struggle for it, and so do with me. We are together, all the lecturers, students are together with this. So I hope that we pray to Allah that Allah will bless us and make everything is smooth. Yeah, inshallah. Okay, so I think that I will stop rather than I keep babbling to you all today. And yeah, meet you again next week, inshallah. This is not YouTubers, huh? Okay, so take care, everyone. Please take care yourself. Keep sanitizing. Use your mask. And yeah, social distancing. Okay. And assalamualaikum. Bye. See you soon.